He saw you before your father gave you a name. Yes. He chose your nativity. Yes. He chose your genealogy.
Yes, he did.
He chose where you were going to be born. Yes. He chose if your eyes were going to be blue or brown.
Yeah.
Or whatever. God knew that. He knew your name before your parents gave it to you. Because he's God. And he knows all things. He's omnipotent. He's omnipresent. He's omniscient. God is all powerful, all wise. He knows all things.
Yes.
And so he was telling the sisters, I said, God is in control of every situation.
Yes, he is.
Of every situation.
Yes, he is.
Because he has a plan. And men can't carry his plan. Men don't have the power to stop God. Men don't have the power. One man goes down, another man comes up. Men try to be dictators. They try to be lords. They try to be harsh. They try to rule over people. They try to get rich over filthy lucre, using the church in the name of the Lord to do so.
All right.
But God knows who they are.
Yes, oh, yes. Yes, he does.
God knows the humble man
over
here in the corner. God knows a man that's sincere. He may have a little of nothing, but God knows who he is. Because the Bible said the Lord knoweth them that are his.
Them that are his.
The Lord knoweth them that are his. And the scripture in Genesis, one of those exact scriptures, one of those exact pinpoint scriptures that you can put a lot of things and see a lot of God in. When Jacob was blessing his 12 sons, and he came to Judah and said he was a lion's whelp, an old lion, couching down by the way. And he said, but the scepter, and a scepter is a rule, it's a king's rule. Scepter's a king's rod. He holds out over the throne, over the people. Said the scepter will not depart from Judah, nor the lawgiver from between his feet, until Shiloh come. Shiloh was Jesus Christ. Jacob prophesied of the coming of Christ hundreds and thousands of years before it ever happened. But he said, it won't come in a haphazard way. God has a plan.
Amen.
God has a plan. He just ain't going to let the Shiloh come through a Reuben. He's unstable as water. He's not going to let it come through Naphtali. He's like the hind turned loose. He's not going to let it come through these others, Simeon, Levi. They're instruments of cruelty. But he said, it will come. It won't depart from Judah. Because Judah was the tribe of praise. Judah was the tribe that gave him glory and praised him and honored him. And he said, the rule of law won't leave that tribe until they birth Shiloh, until Shiloh comes, until Jesus comes. Because that was the plan of God. That was the plan of God, that he would be through that lineage and come through that lineage. And then when you think about the mystery of God, and people wonder about God, and I wonder about God, and you wonder, but God's exact. God is sure.
Amen.
In the book of Proverbs, the 30th chapter of Proverbs, there's a timely scripture right there. He said, who hath bound the wind in his fist? But who hath bound the wind in his fist? And who hath gathered the wind in his fist? And who hath bound the waters in a garment? Who hath ascended up in the heaven and descended? Who hath gathered the wind in his fist or bound the waters in a garment? Who hath established all the ends of the earth? What is his name and what is his son's name, if thou canst tell? Just like over here in Genesis, the scepter will not depart from Judah, nor the lawgiver from between his feet. That was Moses. Moses would always be there in Israel until Shiloh would come. Then he said, in Proverbs, he said, who hath ascended up into heaven and descended? Why, here is a prophecy hundreds and thousands of years before concerning Christ.
Yes.
Concerning the Lord of the church, the head of the body. And here's a a prophecy. The wind in his fist was the day of Pentecost. That man, Jesus, that ascended up into heaven, or descended, was the only one that could gather the wind of the Holy Ghost in his fist, in his hand, and loose it upon about 120. They were there in that upper room, and suddenly he gathered the wind in his fist and loosed it. Suddenly, without any moment, suddenly there came from heaven the sound of a rushing. Where did it come from? It come from the fist of Christ in the heavens. He just, and here come the wind of the Holy Ghost. Praise the name of the Lord. And he baptized about 120. Suddenly there came from heaven the sound of a rushing mighty wind and filled the house where they were sitting. And now he's got one other work to do now before he's finished. He bound the wind in his fist. And he said, he gathered the wind in his fist back there. But now he's got another work in our day. He's not going to gather the wind in his fist now. But he's working on binding of people. Waters typifies people. In the scriptures, water is people. Seas are people. The seas, the water. And now he's gathering. He's not going to work on the Pentecostal experience that he did back there, because he did that back there. And the Holy Ghost is in the earth now. It's loosed. It's out of his fist. It's in the earth right now. But now he's going to gather the people of God, the chosen people, the waters in a garment, the garment of salvation. And while there's sects and while there's organizations and there's creeds and there's all kinds of religious bodies in the earth, but God is slowly gathering some water in the garment. Praise the name of the Lord. Because before the coming of Jesus, he's going to fulfill that work there. You don't have to worry about the body of Christ being divided or separated or split. No man can split the true body of Christ. No man can separate the true body of Christ. Amen. I don't care what he does. I don't care what he does. I don't care how much power he wants. He can't separate those that belong to God. They may be in Haiti. They may be in over here in Georgia. They could be down in Florida, wherever they are, Pennsylvania. But he's going to gather them in a garment, the garment of salvation, and put them there. And finally, his last work, when he comes back again as King of Kings and Lord of Lords, he's not going to gather the wind in his fist. He's not going to bind the waters in a garment. But the last work Christ is going to do, he's going to establish all the ends of the earth. Yes. For 1,000 years, he's going to rule and reign as Lord of Lords and King of Kings, King of Kings, and establish all the ends of his earth. Now, if you understand that, what is his name? And what is his son's name? Praise the name of the Lord. You understand all that? What is his name? His name is Jesus. What is the son's name? His name is Jesus. Praise the name of the Lord. So I love these great, wonderful works of God, and I love the people of God, and my goodness, what a meeting we've had here tonight. And we could preach on and on and on, I doubt that you could stand it on and on and on, so we'll just terminate somewhere and say it's a blessing to be here. It's a blessing to be here. Praise the name. Look at your neighbor and say, it's a blessing to be here. It's a blessing to be here. My goodness sakes alive. You're blessed. You're blessed.
Hallelujah.